What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the last video of the series, we discussed permutations and combinations. So today we're going to follow up on this by tackling subsets, which are a selection of elements in an array. To better grasp the concept, let's take this array of distinct elements as an example. The possible permutations of the elements of this array are the ones you see in front of you, and the total number of these permutations is n factorial. On the other hand, the total number of combinations of 3 elements out of 4, or 4c3, is 4 combinations only. Now, the power set, or total number of subsets that can be generated from this array, are the ones you see, and there is 16 of them, or 2 to the power n, where n equals 4 in this example. Okay, with this out of the way, our goal is to write an algorithm that will generate these subsets for us, just like we generated the permutations and combinations given an array in the previous video. Now, before going any further, I want you to take a closer look at the combinations and subsets we have. You see they are the same, or well, partially the same. The combinations we retrieved here, these 4 arrays, all have a length of 3, and there are only 4 subsets with length 3. So, what does this tell us? Well, let's try to retrieve the combinations for every possible array length. So, 4c4, 4c2, and 4c1. As you can see, every single result taken separately is a combination result, but when we take all these arrays and group them together, we get the power set of that array. Meaning, one way to solve this problem is to make use of the same logic we wrote for the combinations, but instead of calling it for a particular k value, we will call it for every possible k. To implement this, I am going to bring back the combination implementation that uses backtracking, and I am going to wrap our initial recursive call with a for loop that goes from 0 to the length of the input array. Every time we find a combination, we will add it to our solution, which will consist of all the possible subsets of the given array. If you are not familiar with backtracking, feel free to check the video linked in the card above. Now, solving this problem with the help of backtracking is enough, you've done it. But in the next part of this video, I would like to discuss an additional solution to this problem in case the interviewer tried to ask you a follow-up question about it. So, another way of tackling this problem is by generating subsets every time we encounter a new element in the array. Meaning we start with an empty subset in our result list. Then at each step we generate new subsets from the existing ones. So if we had the empty subset at the beginning, when we take the first element into consideration, we're going to add that element to all the subsets we had, in our case only one. When we reach the second element, we add that element to all the subsets we had, allowing us to generate 2 new subsets. So we add them to the 2 we already had. If we keep doing this, we will generate the power set of the given array. To implement this, and as we mentioned, we're going to start by adding an empty array to the output. Then for each element we have inside the given array, we are going to generate new subsets and add them to all the subsets we already generated. To do that, and as we mentioned, we loop over the sets already generated, and each one of them is then used to generate a new subset by adding the element currently being traversed to it. Okay, now, both solutions we wrote have the same complexity, which is n times 2 to the power n, but they do not generate the subsets if the given array contained duplicates. You see, if the interviewer raised the bar and asked a follow-up question saying that you should now generate the unique subsets of a given array, but didn't mention that the elements of that array are unique, so how do we solve that? Well, we could modify this previous implementation and make it work. For instance, we could replace the list of lists with a hash set, and before adding or looping over the elements, we can sort these elements. This will guarantee that the result does not contain duplicates. But is there a better way to do this? Well, yes, there is. And the idea is to eliminate the redundancy happening by generating duplicate subsets and leaving the elimination process in the hands of the set data structure. You see, when you have duplicate elements, like the example in front of you, we will start generating subsets normally, but as soon as we hit a duplicate, we don't need to go all the way to the beginning to generate the subsets, which is what we are currently doing. All we need to do is add the duplicate element to the arrays we just generated, the ones having the duplicated element in question in them. So, in this example, we will generate the following arrays and we will have a complete power set. The implementation of this solution is very similar to the last one. The only tricky part is to find the bounds of the loop we are going to use to generate our subsets when we find the duplicates. Well, these bounds are none other than the previous size of the generated subsets all the way to the end. If you recall the previous example, we had 2 subsets, we then generated an additional 2. For the last iteration, we wanted to go over the last 2 only, which is basically iterating from element 2 to 4, or from the old size to the new size value. And that's it! The link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comment section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.